Hi everyone, I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. There in Argentina, there was a magnitude 6.5 earthquake. It even shook up Yellowstone. Yep, there's the seismic signature as it came in. Really can't see down here at the bottom. They got a lot of magma sloshing around there at Mary Lake. It was deep, about 137 miles or 210 kilometers. It was close to, or probably part of the El Tigre fault system. That fault system, let me see here, I believe is about, 120 kilometers long, 75 miles long. What we have going on here is a slab from the Nazca plate subducting underneath the South American plate. You see, this is kind of a short little fault compared to other faults there in South America, but it's very significant. The subducted slab is east dipping and it's very shallow. They got some really big scarps along in this area for this fault zone. There hasn't been any reports of injuries or damage. It is a sparsely populated area through here. There was a few reports sent into EMSC for those that did feel it. It says, didn't know felt, was really strong, that a brick fell on my car. Okay, long but not strong. See, in this report here was 263 kilometers northwest. So that would be about 164 miles. Now that comes from Chile. The other report in Jury, Argentina was 154 kilometers. The person that said they had a brick fall on their car. So that would be about 97 miles. Another one from Chile. Tremor large, duration large. Okay, let's see if we can translate this one. Comes from Chile. There was two tremors, but was moderately strong. I thought the second one was going to take off. Well, it didn't, so that's good. Soft but long. Another one from Chile. Let's see, very light but long. I noticed the water can we have at work. I guess it was shaking. That was in Chile. Let's see, it was trembling. A lot of reports from Chile. Let's see. I'm not going to try and pronounce that. It was not so strong, but felt long. Let's see. A little longer than the previous one and stronger. Let's see. A single strong and short movement. The previous one was not felt. Okay. Quite strong. I would say vertical motion, quite long. The phone application warned me before seismic movement. So they got an earthquake warning. That's kind of cool. It felt strong and long as if divided into two batches. Okay. Strong rocking motion. If it was on the second floor, there was a lot of noise and strong shaking. The previous one, more than 30 minutes ago, was much milder. I'm going to have to see if they got another earthquake reported. Long lasting, short movement. All right, there's a 6.5. It says 130 miles in depth. There's another one. Maybe a half an hour earlier. A 5.3. That one was also as deep. 131.7 miles. That one's France. Okay. Change it over to where it only shows for this location. For the 5.3 that came in before the 6.5, yeah, it was a thrust earthquake. You can see we got spreading. Yeah. There's its location, and let's bring this out so you can see it was along the same fault zone, south. More likely, the fault zone ruptured, and you can see here the direction on this side of the fault zone. It would be moving south, and then to the west of the fault zone, it would be moving north. USGS says it was at Jujuy, Argentina. Oh boy, that's a long ways away. Okay, there's Jujuy. And let's bring it out. 88.6 miles. Or let's see, let's go to kilometers. 142 kilometers. There is only one felt report sent into EMSE, and it says it was slow and didn't last long. That's the only report. The report of the one that said they had a brick fall in their car came from San Salvador, El Jujuy. So going to Google Earth, yeah, I just picked any old road there in the town. There's a lot of brick structures. All right, here's another area, part of the town. I wonder if those are olive trees. Yeah, who knows where the brick may have come from. More than likely from the top of a building. I mean, you can look here and see how, yeah, things are, yeah, they even got brick laying down there at the bottom. Maybe they're working on that, I don't know. Kind of nice, you know, using Google Earth. Oh, there's aluminum foil on the top of that. Looks like a lamp post. But anyways, it's kind of nice traveling around the world using Google Earth. Well, I hope it certainly doesn't mean there's going to be another larger earthquake coming. Yeah, those people don't need to have more devastation added to their probably very tough lives. Sending prayers. Yeah, if you have family there, yeah, did they have damage? USGS only gave it an intensity level of 4, but that is because of the very few reports that they got. Only 10 people sent in reports. Let's take a look. All right, here's where the earthquake occurred, the 6.5 intensity level 4. And then Salta, intensity level 3. All right, that's all they got posted on here. So what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please like, share, and subscribe. I'm also on Twitter. Oh, we got some more over here. So you can follow me on Twitter if you like. Let's see. There was 3 reports from there. Intensity level 4. And as always, be prepared for a disaster. You just don't know when it could strike. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.